38 years of age.
Are you beeping at me?
No, I was beeping at the video. Genuine running condition. 78 Mitsubishi Colt flat deck truck T120-Y. Some condensation, which you'd expect after sitting for several years. Only run now and again. Still runs sweet. All the extras, or some of the extras should I say. Spare window glass from one of my other ones, IJ3960, which was a 77 Mitsi Colt. This of course is a 78. And that's from the 75, and that's from the 77. Back windows spare. I have a total of 15 13 inch rims. I was trying to figure out where the others went to. I have three without rubber and the rest with. I was trying to figure out where the others went. Then I realized I forgot five mud and snow all-terrain grips for the unit at the moment, and as you can see, they're reasonably good tread. That's a mud grip as well. So, yeah. Now, this rear frame is removable when you unbolt these two bolts here, either side, stop it out. That's it, back to a flat deck. I have the sides and tailgate off one of the others, and I think that's just a tailgate off the other one because it was crappy, it all fell to pieces. Now I have all of these in the shed. I must get them out. All these, so that'll be four. I got four, four, six, four, eight. Yeah, probably a dozen of those now. I've got some spare one of these in the box, or two of those in the box. I have a spare light, one for the other side, but I figured out that was far better. Stuck a lot further out, you can see better. Now this A-frame, those are actually front steering ball joint fittings from one of the other trucks. So you can understand that that's as strong as a knob of goat shit. And that's a bulldozer cutter bar. And that's been arc welded onto this. These socks are held on by a meter long inch bolt, and it's all pinned together with safety pins. There's a trailer connector here because that comes off this, and another extension goes from there across to the back, which couples into the trailer socket, which is that cable there, of course, and it couples into the trailer socket because this thing, when it's run off road, it can actually tow a trailer, the likes of that, but you're not getting. Right, what else is there? Oh yes, there's a spare steering wheel, and was a, thankfully I've saved one of these. It's a headlight dip switch, because the one in the truck is, the spring is gone, so it's no good. This here is the box of parts. That's a couple of spare windscreen wipers. As you can see, one dashboard. Now don't worry about that, because that's got screws inside it, the best way to keep screws. There's a new oil filter that I haven't put on yet. This one is the same, but it's got broken, so it's only here for the lights, because these are all replacement lights, all the globes for the unit. So if you do get a crap out, one of these gauges buggers out, you can just swap it over, not a problem. Now the switches, there's a whole heap of, here you go, these are these spare grills for the side of that side of the cab, the three of those there. The other one off the other truck is buggered. Now this is, that's a light switch, that's a light switch, that's also a, no, that's a wiper switch, that one. There's another one around here somewhere. There must be another wiper switch around here somewhere. Yeah, there's another, no, that's another headlight switch. So you can see, enough bits to keep you happy. One of those vents. Right, inside here we have the 78 workshop manual. We have the 4G Neptune motor manual, genuine Mitsubishi unit, in English by the way. And that's the workshop manual, the supplement 1978 workshop manual, because here's the 77 workshop manual, the whole chassis group. That's the whole lot, vans, pickups, buses, you name it. And here's the parts catalogue for all of them, individually itemised, and you can figure out what they are, who they are, how they are, etc. It even goes right through to give the parts catalogue, chassis and body group applicable for export models T120, T120V, T120C, 78 model year, printed in November 77, and it gives the truck, the T120SR Colt pickup, right hand drive, SL, left hand drive, HSR, which is a high sided drop sider, right hand drive, HSL, left hand, ER, which is a four door van, QER, five door van, QEL, which is a five door deluxe van. You can get it, you get the drift. Right, so that's all of these. And as on Wikipedia, or Wikia, tractorswikia.com, I put these up here. This one is either one of these or one of those. I don't know whether it's the drop side or the well deck. But when they arrived in Alexandria, they took that off and they put these uber wide or super wide flat decks, custom made in Alexandria. Put them on. This is a 2 meter wide one, the widest they made. A lot of others were narrower. Most people cut them back down to about this size in later years without realizing what they were. There's the van, work van, the panel van, and the bus. So all of these have got all of their bits and pieces. You can figure out what they are, how they are. You might still be able to get them, I wouldn't have a clue. All the part numbers, someone in the world must have them. There's just all the panels and how to and where to wire them, and you go figure, right? And there's a spare photocopied one for the parts if you want to get your fingers dirty or just take a page to a supplier. Right, so all those are there. Right, so that's why it's the truck carts manual and the copy and all the rest of it. Right, now that's about all you need to know. The rest of it, as they say, will be history when you buy it. Now I just put some petrol in the van, so that's sweet. It's still got its genuine heater, though never any good. It's got a stupid little warehouse radio I put in years ago with a couple of speakers. It doesn't work. I think the fuse blown, but I don't care. Now, it has a genuine Hillman Hunter jack. Why? Well, as you can see on the A-frame, there are a couple of little holes there, pipe fittings, where this fits into, so that when you are going to tow, you've got a nice, easy, height adjustable A-frame that'll go onto your tow ball. There's a spark plug spanner which fits that, which fits the wheel nuts, which fits spark plugs even. Now, it comes with a jack and a handle, and for some reason or other two spanners, but yeah, I might have to remove one of those. What's that one? That's, oh, I know why, that was for the car. Yeah, so that's one there. That's the original, which is a tiny little wee thing. Yeah. But that fits in there. Now that's not an original jack, because the original jack was as useless as the things on a ball. So I put that one in there. You wind it up to keep it trapped in there. Right, and that, oh, that comes up for the motor underneath, which you can hear running. Oh, that belongs to another. That belongs to another jack. Right, so that's it. Right, it's got an all-round mirror. I put an all-round mirror, a wide angle, so you can see all over the place. And that's it. Oh. This, it's a safety held handle for the A-frame, so that when you drop it down, it's sweet. If you want to, you can put a rope on here, put on there if you forget to use the jack, but there's the holes for the jack. And it's a dual use farm type coupler, which means you can use 1 7/8 or 50 mil tow balls. You can interchange that, doesn't matter. They fit both. Right, there's a spare mirror somewhere. There's a radio mount that my son went under a tree and broke the aerial, and that was the end of that. So it's still connected in there somewhere. Now I've got an extra battery on here jump starting it, because as you can understand, sitting for a while it got flat, because long ago I put a jump starter point there. It's got a bracket there, you earth it with, and, or you can earth it up here, I don't care where you earth it, but you can jump start it if you like, because this battery was absolutely looted, as they saying goes. It's supposed to be maintenance free, but it died years ago. Anyway, but that's what was in it, a CCA 309 plate. Tiny little what's that type? HNS40Z, but I don't think it was the right one. It's currently got another 12 volt battery in there, and this one's jumping it, but you'll only get the one that's fitted in the truck. Which, by the way, if I take this off and disconnect that, we're now running on the internal battery, because this isn't fitted anymore. Right. Alright, now, you'll say, well, you haven't got the battery connected. Well, wrong, there's one inside the truck. This is just here as an extra. Just to make sure that charges up properly. Right. Now, as I say, this dip switch isn't holding up. It should click either way. It should go click, 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 but it hold it, but it's not. So either that or there's a relay down there that's wrong. I can't remember. I think it's a selector that goes up and stays up. Yep. So that's just a simple replacement. All you do, whoop. Ah, shut up. You turn that off. Parked away again. So